So, you have a movie for me?
Yes, sir, I do. It's called Lord of the Rings.
Oh, like a Sonic the Hedgehog movie?
No, it's based on the Lord of the Rings fantasy books, like this one's about the Fellowship of the Ring.
Okay, so what happens in this thing?
Well, we're gonna meet this bad guy, Sauron, right? And he's super evil.
And what's his deal, like, character-wise?
He's super evil.
I love it.
And he has this ring that makes him super powerful, so he's just massacring people left and right on a battlefield. I mean, this guy's really good at killing.
Okay.
And then he, like, reaches out to this human, Isildur, who cuts off his finger, which makes the ring fall and destroys him.
Why did he reach out for him?
To kill him, I guess.
Did he not have a weapon?
No, he did. He had like a big mace thing.
So why did he reach out with his hand?
I don't know.
All right, then keep your secrets.
Anyway, so then that guy and this elf Elrond, they head up to this Mount Doom place because they have to throw this ring into some fire. That's the only way to destroy it and rid the world of evil.
Right.
But this human guy, he's like, you know, actually, I'm gonna keep it. I like it, so I'm gonna keep it and it's mine now.
Wow, does Elrond try to stop him?
Of course he does.
Okay, good.
Verbally, a little.
Yeah, seems like a lot of potential problems could be avoided if you put a bit more effort into that.
Probably. So anyway, years later, this hobbit creature, Bilbo Baggins, he has the ring now.
Okay.
And he's having this big birthday party at this hobbit place called the Shire.
Fun.
So his buddy, this wizard Gandalf, shows up and they smoke their pipes together. They have a great time. Bilbo's like, ah, this is the finest weed in the area.
Oh, it's like that, huh?
No, it's not like that.
Oh.
Anyway, so eventually Gandalf finds out about the ring and he tells Bilbo's sort of adopted nephew Frodo about it, because Bilbo, he left.
And what does he say?
Well, that Sauron's life force is bound to the ring and he just needs to get the ring back to come back and be evil all over the place.
Oh, yikes, for sure.
Yeah, and there are some really creepy ring servant guys called the Nazgul and they're coming for the ring and they are intense.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, and they're on their way to the Shire and they know that somebody named Baggins has it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so Gandalf tells Frodo that he and his buddy Samwise, they need to get out of the Shire.
Okay.
And Gandalf, he takes off to go see this other wizard, Saruman.
And how does that go?
Oh, not well. It turns out that he's evil now, and he forces Gandalf to breakdance against his will.
Very rude.
And Frodo and Sam, they meet up with these other hobbits, Merry and Pippin, and eventually the Nazgul catch up to all of them.
Oh, dang it.
Yeah, and like I said, these things are intense. Like, they chop a guy's head off on sight, unprovoked.
Very scary, so I guess they must massacre the hobbits in the same way, huh?
No, they kind of just shove Sam and Merry and Pippin to the side out of the way.
Oh,
and then one of them stabs Frodo.
Oh boy, here we go. They kill Frodo, huh? Wow.
No, just like a little shoulder stab.
Oh.
And then this guy Aragorn that the hobbits were hanging out with, he shows up to help. So he kind of shoos them away with some fire and they all run away.
I gotta say, these Nazgul seem less and less threatening with every sentence you say.
Well, no, they're super deadly, just not with the main characters because they need to be alive for the story.
Oh, very story considerate Nazgul.
Anyway, so after the breakdancing incident, Gandalf gets put on this super high tower with no walls.
Wow, it's gonna be tough for him to get out of there.
Actually, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he talks to a moth and then an eagle friend shows up and he flies away.
Oh, a very helpful bird.
Yeah, and so Saruman, he's helping Sauron build an army of orcs.
And these things are crazy. I mean, they're born fully grown, covered in goo. Oh, samesies.
What?
What?
So eventually the good guys get to this elf place called Rivendell and they have a big council meeting with a bunch of different races.
Okay.
And they're all kind of just arguing about how to get this ring to Mount Doom and Mordor, right?
Right.
And Frodo finally steps forward like, hey, I'll bring the ring to Mordor. I can't get corrupted. I don't really care about power and stuff.
Pretty nice of him.
Yeah, and so Aragorn is like, you have my sword. And this elf Legolas, he's like, you have my bow.
What? Why is everybody accusing him of theft all of a sudden?
No, they're saying they're gonna go with them.
Then say that, you weirdos.
So they end up forming the Fellowship of the Ring.
That's the name of the thing.
It is.
Wow.
So then the Fellowship, they're gonna start walking, right?
Okay.
And they're gonna keep walking, and also they're gonna walk so much, dude.
Okay, yeah, sounds kind of boring.
Actually, it's gonna be nice to look at because we're gonna showcase the beautiful scenery of New Zealand.
Oh, we are.
Yeah, just stunning landscapes. New Zealand is truly a beautiful place.
Okay, I mean, yeah, sure. So then what happens?
Well, there's gonna be a fight in a mine with some orcs and a troll. Frodo's gonna get stabbed again.
Oh, that guy's always getting stabbed.
Yeah, but this time he's wearing a nice little dress, so it all works out.
What?
Well, technically it's chainmail, but it's definitely gonna look like he's headed to prom right after the battle.
Well, okay then.
And then Gandalf, he's gonna have to stand up to this big fire demon, and he's gonna end up falling.
Oh, where does he fall?
Into the sequel.
Okay, great.
And then the good guys are gonna get attacked by orcs again.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, and this one guy, Boromir, he was being kind of sketchy about the ring, but then he ends up dying trying to save Merry and Pippin.
Oh, he's gonna die, huh? Definitely gonna get Sean Bean for that part then.
Okay, why are you producer people so obsessed with killing that guy?
Killing Sean Bean is tight.
Fair enough. So anyway, then Frodo and Sam, they take off in a boat, and everybody else, they go try to save Merry and Pippin, because they got captured.
Very exciting. And so, yeah, I'll be back to tell you about part two soon. But shouldn't we wait to see how this first one performs?
No, I want to shoot these all at once.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You in?
I mean, I guess. I do have a question, though.
What's up?
Well, I mean, if Gandalf has access to eagles, why not fly the ring to Mordor?
Oh, well, I mean, there are a couple of reasons why that's not really a possibility.
Okay, do you think maybe we should explain some of those in the movie?
No, I trust that everyone's gonna figure it out for themselves, and it won't lead to any confusion ever.
That is how these things usually go.
Hey guys, it's Ryan here. Hope you like that pitch meeting. There are over 100 episodes of Pitch Meeting on the channel that you could check out. I also have some other videos on there, so click around. Also, let me know in the comments section what other movies you'd like to see these pitches for. Don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, the bell button, the button, I don't know. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.